Good news for flood-stricken provinces as the low-pressure area off eastern Samar has dissipated, but moderate to heavy rains are still expected in parts of Luzon. Let's get the latest weather update now from PAGASA weather forecaster Veronica Torres. Good afternoon, Veronica. Go ahead.
Good afternoon to you and to all of our listeners. As of 11 a.m. today, we have issued a weather advisory for Sheerlan. And as of 8 a.m. today, the low pressure southeast of Gian Eastern Samar has dissipated. And in the next 24 hours, the Sheerlan will be moderate to heavy with at times intense rains over Cagayan, Isabela, Aurora, Quezon, and Mindoro provinces, while light to moderate with at times heavy rains will also be experienced over Camarines Norte and the rest of Calabarzon and Mimaropa. So those living in flood-prone and landslide-prone areas ay pinag-iingat po natin. And also, we have a gale warning over the seaboards of Luzon and eastern seaboards of Visayas and Mindanao. So our countrymen with small sea vessels are alerted against high waves. And that's the latest from PAGASA Weather Forecasting Center, Veronica Torres.
Yes, Veronica, a few questions for you. So yung mga, kung nasaan yung reporter namin kanina, si Jervis Manahan, nasa may Misamis Occidental siya. At napuruhan siya ng mga baha, ano? So itong mga residenteng ito, ligtas na ba sila sa panganib? Hindi na ba uulan sa kanilang mga areas?
Sa kasalukuyan po, base po sa ating huling pagtaya, sa mga susunod na araw, nananatili po, inaikita po natin yung pagpapatuloy po na magandang panahon, katulad po ng panahon natin ngayon dito sa May Mindanao area. However, pinag-iingat pa rin po natin yung ating mga kababayan dahil may mga chance pa rin po ng mga isolated rain showers and thunderstorms. And also, ingat pa rin din po kasi yung mga epekto ng mga areas na bumaha and also kung sa mga nakatira sa mga landslide-prone areas, ay ingat pa rin po tayo dyan.
Oo, kasi malambot na yung lupa, no? So kapag
yes,
meron
po
pang kaunting pag-ulan, saturated na kasi. So hindi dahil maganda na yung panahon, hindi na sila naligtas na sila sa panganib, Veronica.
Opo, tama po yun.
Okay, maraming salamat. Veronica, thanks. And to you and the rest of the team there, maraming salamat. And again, we appreciate all that you do.
Thank you.
Crowds are beginning to form at seaports in the country, with passengers hoping to make it to their destinations to ring in the new year. Let's check on the situation at the Batangas port. Dennis Dato now joins us live from there. Dennis, tell us more about what's happening from where you're at.
Yes, Carmina, more and more passengers are arriving here at Batangas port to go home to their families in their provinces so they can welcome the new year together. Ticket buyers must have patience because there is always a long line for those going to Calapan City, Abra de Ilog, and Puerto Galera. Aside from those returning home to their families, many passengers are foreign tourists heading to Puerto Galera for vacation. Port management expects that today there will be more passengers who will pass through the Batangas port to go home to their province for the New Year celebration. Many Filipinos prefer to go home for the New Year celebration rather than Christmas because others still have work. Calapan Port in Oriental Mindoro also saw an influx of passengers heading to Batangas and Metro Manila. According to Calapan Port manager Elvis Medalla, last Tuesday, 4,600 passengers left Calapan Port, while yesterday it reached 5,263. According to Medalla, due to the large number of passengers, the ships could not accommodate all the passengers. Many vehicles of rolling cargoes were also stranded for 2 days in the holding area designated by the local government unit of Calapan City because on Tuesday, the number of rolling cargoes was 901, while yesterday it was 1,002. Some of the problems are the lack of number of ships because there are only 10 ships that travel back and forth between Calapan and Batangas. So during peak season, they cannot handle the number of passengers. The trip also takes longer when the weather is bad like today, resulting in some delays. Adding to the problem on Tuesday and yesterday was the collapse of fast catch ship ramps at Batangas port, causing them to unable to travel. But last night, the fast catch started sailing again after the ramp was repaired and after the safety engineers ensured that it was safe to use. Because of this, before noon today, there are no more stranded rolling cargoes in Calapan. Back here at Batangas port tomorrow, there may be an influx of passengers going home to the provinces because there will be no work tomorrow, Carmina.
Right. Dennis, just one question. When is the last trip out of the port for 2022?
Okay. There's no cancellation. The port, the ship will not stop operating even on New Year's Eve and on first day of the year, January 1.
Okay. So anong oras yung pinakahuling biyahe mula dyan sa port?
Every 2 hours, umaalis yung mga barko dito sa Batangas Port, lalo na yung Montenegro Shipping Line, yung patungong Calapan.
Aha, okay. So ingat-ingat lang dyan. Dennis Dato there, joining us live from the Batangas Port. Dennis, Happy New Year!